Hey guys, it's Mike here. One go short play. Today we're playing the awesome game.
Awesome Kickstarter machine.
That is.
I'm awesome.
Awesome Possum. Open brackets. Kickstarter machinos, but close brackets. I don't know if you detected an element of slight sarcasm there in my use of the word awesome. The fact is. I've had far too much trouble recording this game over the last few days, to the point where I actually gave up on it. Just technical stuff, nothing major, but one thing that really got on my whiff during that recording process was, unfortunately, this game. It's like an attempt at Sonic the Hedgehog without anything that made Sonic the Hedgehog good. Now, Sonic the Hedgehog was really all about very nice controls. Kind of a gimmick-free game environment. I don't know those elements.
Amazing.
I don't know if I'd call them gimmicks, but just features of the game's gameplay of Sonic that made it quite unique. Awesome Possum seems to have copied a lot of that. It's also taken a few ideas from the whole Amiga platformer kind of world, and as a result, this doesn't feel, oh, look at that for nastily hidden, doesn't feel so much like a nice Sonic the Hedgehog clone as a really nasty attempt at reproducing Sonic the Hedgehog's success. Via a really rubbish game. Did that make sense? Kind of. I mean, I'm so sick of the sight of this game. I'm not really into talking about it. I just don't want to talk about it. I do like the cool little leaf effect when it lands. That's kind of cool. Like that. The first time, maybe the second time. It's not very slick though, is it? The game is very, very ropey. It's as ropey as it looks. Now, maybe part of what you're seeing is down to the frame rate of the video. I do find that I'm having a few minor problems with that. Now I'm recording my own my own voice onto the video. Let's just try and get to the end of the level without messing about. I found a few slight frame rate problems, but nothing that really plays on, that makes the game look much worse than it is. This actually plays that badly. The frame rate is actually that weird. It's that jerky. It's that jagged. There's that word again. Which shouldn't really come into play with a Mega Drive game, should it? It's jagged. It's. I'm trying to. Ooh, hello, secret entrance. I'm trying to give you an example. Well, the scrolling alone kind of shows you, doesn't it? I mean, there's no gradient to that movement. There's no. What do they call it? What did I call it when I was reading about it when I was learning to program? Incremental and decremental, I guess integers, variables, whatever. Number that counts down when you come to a stop. You know, Sonic would go scared. And there's an element of it. It's just, it feels really, really, it feels rubbish. It's like they've gone, yeah, that'll do, and left it. Whereas in a game like Sonic, they've gone, no, that won't do. We'll do it properly. You saw the kind of jaggedness of all that then, didn't you, when that floor went? It's hard to control yourself during those sequences. Really? Man, that sucked. It's hard to control yourself when anything happens in this game, it just becomes really, really kind of rough to control. You end up letting go of the pad, just hoping that you're not going to kind of run into whatever you've already run into, because it's kind of too late. Not a great game. Awesome Possum, possibly the worst platformer I've played so far on the Mega Drive, and I have played a few. I do like all that though, and I do like his voice much, regardless of how annoying he is. There's a nice idea in it, in that he's got some elements of artificial intelligence, and he's responding to situations, and he's interacting with the other player. And I like that idea. It's just kind of not very well educated. Not very well, what was the word I was looking for? Well, not very well pulled off in this. And that's a shame. Well, it's not really, because it's not a very good game anyway. Awesome Possum Sega Mega Drive. Thank you very much for watching.